Here are 5 comic books you can pick up that will add immediate value to your collection. Hey there. In this video, I'll be reviewing 5 comic book value picks from mid-May 2022 that I shared on social media and compare the values I shared at the time with the current values in a retrospective format. And then we can review how the values have changed since then. My goal with these comic book picks is to try to select about 1 comic book a day and share it with you if it meets the following criteria. First, the comic book has relative affordability with a low or minimal buy-in. Second, the value of the book has a wide range between the reported fair market value provided by cover price for a raw copy and the graded value of the book in a 9.8 provided by GPA. And third, the average value for a CGC 9.4 is high enough where the amount is at least at or above the cost to acquire the book after grading and shipping fees. The suggested price that I share is offered to you only as a guide to keep your purchasing budget in line with the value data. This means that the pick is only worthy of you pursuing it if you can acquire the book raw in near mint condition or in a 9.4, but hopefully a 9.6 or 9.8, and if you intend to send the book in for professional grading. Now, let's get to the picks. On May 13th, 2022, I shared Moon Knight number 26, released in December of 1982, written by Doug Mensch with interior and cover art by Bill Sienkiewicz. The fair market value of this book has risen 15.4% for a gain of $1.56 up to $11.69. However, the last sale of this book in a 9.8 has dropped 16.5% for a loss of $98 down to $495. The 9.4 average has also fallen down 23% for a loss of $16.50 all the way down to $55. On May 14th, 2022, I shared Terminator number 1 from August 1990, written by John Arcudi, with art by Chris Warner. This book has lost over 50% of its fair market value, down $4.03 to $3.77. The last sale of this book is still being reported as $140, and the CGC 9.4 average is still $32.50. So while the graded copy values are holding, the fair market value has fallen, which should give you an opportunity to grab this book for even less. On May 15th, 2022, I shared Spawn number 327, released in March 2022, written by Todd McFarlane and Rory McConville, with art by Carlo Barberi and cover art by Todd McFarlane. This is a homage to McFarlane's own cover for Spider-Man number 1. The fair market value of this book has risen 38.85%, up $1.76 to $6.29 for a raw copy. However, the last reported sale of this book in a 9.8 has fallen all the way down to $90 for a loss of 26.83%. While there is no 9.4 average for this book, the 90-day average for this book in a CGC 9.8 dropped $5 down to $97 for a loss of 4.9%. This is still a great pickup if you can grab it at cover price, as collectors are continually on the hunt for both McFarlane books and homage covers. On May 16th, 2022, I shared Ghost Rider number 5, released back in August 1990, written by Howard Mackey, with interior art by Mark Teixeira and cover art by Jim Lee. This book has lost 28.67% of its fair market value down $1.84 to $4.58. The last sale of this book in a 9.8 rose $2 up to $105 for a gain of almost 2%. There was no change in the CGC 9.4 average, holding at $35.50. On May 17th, 2022, I shared X Factor number 71 from October 1991, written by Peter David, with pencils and cover art by Larry Stroman. This book is considered a key as it features the first team appearance of the new X Factor: Havoc, Polaris, Madrox, Wolfsbane, and Strong Guy. This book's fair market value has increased 26.23%, up $1.60, to $7.70. However, the last reported sale of this book tumbled 62.42% for a CGC 9.8, down $93 to $56. The 9.4 average also fell 11.76%, down $5 to $37.50. And those are my picks. Be sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Moneyball Comics to receive these picks daily in your feed and watch the value pick retrospectives here on my channel. Thanks for watching, happy collecting, and see you next time.